Welcome back to a playthrough by That One Gamer, and welcome back to Super Star Wars playthrough on the Super Nintendo on the Virtual Console. So we got through the land of the Sand People and the land of the Banthas, and now we're getting into Mos Eisley. And this will be the last level where you can only play as Luke in the game. And then we'll be able to play as another character at the end of this level. After this level. So here we go. And this will be the first level to introduce the Stormtroopers. And, somehow they drop from above. But literally from nowhere. Ooh, helpful. And this level will have no boss at the end of it, so you don't have to stop too much on health swords. But you do need to be careful, because it can be easy to die on some parts here. There are no pits, mind you, but there are some of those spiked leaves that you saw down there that can cause a good amount of damage. Remember these creatures? They had little to no movement in the original version. They were dewbacks. Oh yeah, those missile things that they had. The dudes with the fire flame blasts are just completely stationary, and they don't move or anything like that. Whereas regular stormtroopers can be annoying, and the missile launcher ones, like that dude, is deadly, so... Okay, let's move here. Yeah, just what I need. And they don't turn around either, apparently. Ooh, that's all. But the flamethrower dudes do, and the missile launcher dudes do have a little bit more health, so be careful. One over here. What about that name, guys? I think if there's enough blaster power-ups in this one, that you could start from a blaster and then end up with a plasma by the time you reach the end of the level. I can't remember how many I've got. I know I got at least two so far. Or found two blaster power-ups. There's a third one. Missiles will seek you out, kind of like your own seeker do it for the other enemies. Look at that. Shield! Yay! Jabba, you're still around. Can't remember. This might be the last level where you encounter the Jabbas. I might be wrong on that. Could be two levels in from here. Nothing there. Dang it. You fall down there, you have to worry about the spiky green plant stuff, I think. Yep. Now, if you had a barrel to run across to take you all the way across, that'd be fine. And the thermal detonator, interesting thing about that, if you don't pick it up in time, I think it could blow up and provide, result in some shrapnel appearing, which could actually damage you. And you'll probably still notice with these stormtroopers, when they fire blasts at you, it's not the normal Star Wars blast, it's these red circular object things. And also, these guys will try to get onto the same level as you. So if you're a level below, they'll look left and right, and then drop down a level to match your height. But they can't jump high, though. Alright. There we go. It's Chewie! And I'm definitely going to play as him in the next level. So I'll show a little some stats about the characters here. 5'9", 19, a Blast Tech BL-22 pistol, and a Tatooine. And here's Chewbacca, 8 feet, 200 years old, a crossbow FD-011, and from Kashyyyk. Now, Chewbacca, if you happen to die in a level and then choose Chewie, you'll start with the flamethrower weapon, and you'll start with three more health swords. I can tell you, in this level, you want to be Chewie. Because the boss is the second hardest boss in the game. It's the Cantina! I almost said Cutina, that's Star Fox. Nothing too fancy here, just take out all the enemies that appear in each little section. And hopefully some will drop some health swords. And these enemies here, they will jump after you once you get close enough. Blue ones only give you a little heart, but the red ones give you a big one. Surprisingly, they do a lot of damage, but you only get 50 points for them. But, okay, after this section here, I believe is a checkpoint where you do not get that one blast of power. Ooh, that's all. Hey, there's the band! You cannot hold a thermal detonator indefinitely, by the way. Yeah, health sword! Health sword, yeah! You look really good, man. Getting lucky. One more health sword. But not enough to do anything. Alright, the boss here is actually one of those pieces from the Star Wars chess thing that R2 and Chewie were playing with. R2 took out one of Chewie's pieces with what the boss looks like. Now this boss is tricky. It attacks you by either punching you or extending its long head out. What's interesting thing is it tries to match an exact distance away from you. If you try to walk after him, he will back up. But then when you walk away from him, he won't immediately move towards you, and that's the secret to the trick to beating him. So keep that in mind as I go up against him. Oh, there's the band again. That's weird. There we go. Sometimes he'll move towards you and sometimes he won't. So you just have to work with this. Oof, I really lucked out there. Seeker missiles are very useful here. That way you can fire regardless of whatever direction you're facing. So after you beat this boss, Han Solo. This looks kind of weird in 16-bit graphics, but, so, Han Solo, I will play as him, but like Chewie, if you happen to die and then select Han, you'll start with the flame weapon. But you don't start with additional health swords. So, 6 feet, 31 years old, Blastech DL-44 pistol. Unknown origin at the time this game came out, but he was actually from Corneria, as we were able to find out in the N64 Rogue Squadron game. I like how Han shoots above him; just doesn't even look. This one, you will definitely want to try to max out health swords. So thankfully, the stormtroopers are almost infinite, it seems. Ooh, four times. I haven't seen that enemy since the droid thing, since the outside the sand crawler. Oh, now I've got to. Now I'm getting the health swords. What the heck? Remember right, looking at the difficulty and how much health the hearts gives you, I want to say in easy mode, the hearts give you the same amount of health as like a health sword would give you. In brave, it gives you about 3/4 of it, and in Jedi mode, it gives you half a health sword of health, if that makes sense. So basically, if you get a health sword, it takes 2 hearts exactly to fill it up. Whereas in be wrong on that. I guess it does take 3/4. Maybe on Brave it's 1 full, and easy it's like 1.5 or something. Sometimes I thought it was full, 3/4, and half. Oh well. Yeah, let's fight on the barrel. A random bit of trivia. If you were wondering, like, what part of the movie you hear some of this music, like the first level and the Land of the Sand People, it's comes during the Battle of Yavin. Oh, come on! Seriously? When the TIE fighters arrive. Pick up your visual scanning! Here they come! And then the music comes in. This one here is when Luke puts away the targeting computer. And on the level where you're attacking the Jawas on that Mode 7 place, that was when the TIE fighters are attacking the Millennium Falcon after they just got out escaping the Death Star. Oh, let's get some health swords. Because there's not very many after you get past the mini boss in this level. Okay, so these guys will not really come around. Come on, give me some health swords! And obviously the music, going back to the music, Sandcrawler came from the music. Sandcrawler music in the game came from Sandcrawler in the movie. I'll move that later. Nice. Come on. I like how his projectile just floated there. Over here. There we go. There we go. So get up to 5 more, and I know there's 1 after the mini boss. Only 1 that I know of. I know in later games, each of the characters gain new special abilities. Like, Han gets to throw grenades. Chewie has a type of spin move that is invincible and does damage to enemies that he clotheslines. Luke can, in later games, blast, or reflect blaster fire and some other enemy projectiles. But also, use the Force abilities, some of the Force abilities. And to answer your question, I do have Super Empire Strikes Back and Super Return of the Jedi on Virtual Console. The trouble is, Super Empire Strikes Back, I have yet to beat that game without passwords on Brave Mode. because of that one level after your Battle of Hoth, after you've taken out ATSTs and AT-ATs in that mode 7 level, the part where you have to flying a snow speeder in 2D and you have to destroy a bunch of flying snow troopers to advance. Simply touching them damages the frickin' snow speeder. How does that make any sense? I can't ever seem to figure out the pattern to take out enough of them before losing all my health. After that I could, yes, because I have done it, but not in one long, full playthrough. So, come on! I think out of all the Star Wars movies I've seen thus far, oh, looks like we ran out finally. I think the original, A New Hope, is my favorite of the bunch. Just really like the characters and the story and the music, especially at the credits at the very end when they Han and Luke are given the medals ceremony. Just love that music. It's the best Star Wars part of music right there. Dang it. This is the last section here before the mini boss. Looks like, I just noticed, that you can only have one stormtrooper come from above at one, on one screen. So, another stormtrooper will not drop down until you either, left him behind, advance to far enough, or, you're taking one out. Oh, can you get shields or something that we use to help take out the mini boss? Drop something! This is really annoying. Guess I got all the health swords I could before this level, I don't know. I don't think I noticed. Did it say an extra 1-up awarded earlier? Because I noticed I just have over 100,000 points, but I don't recall seeing the extra life awarded thing. I missed that. I like when I blast, but they're only moving because he's sticking out from the top of the screen there. Well, it doesn't look like anything's gonna happen, so. Well, come on! Really? Alright, let's see if I can do this without all the help. So, has three health bars, actually. So, basically, you just crouch and fire and ultimately, you should take them out, but sometimes it can be a crap. There's there's an item up there, but I just want to make sure I was able to show you before I advanced. So this part, there's a bunch of these mines that like cover the air, like right down there. And so they'll explode after some time has passed. There's that health sword, I knew it was. But from now on, I will no longer see any regular stormtroopers. I'll only see the ones that fire those flame blasts or the missile things. And there's a, you know, these droids appear, which I want to say is kind of like the one from Return of the Jedi, where he's talking, where they talked with C-3PO and R2-D2 after they got taken into Jabba's custody. Could be wrong. Oh, there was a shield over there. I was too slow to get it. Oh yeah, watch out for those things, because those things do a lot of damage, and the shrapnel appears when you destroy them. Blaster power up. Okay. So just give it a few seconds for those things to explode. They continue on, because they do not reappear. Oh, there are two of them. And just in time. I was going to say, the health swords do disappear if you give it too much time. And you saw it there, because I was too far. It was so close to the edge of the screen that those things quickly fell off the screen and no shrapnel appeared. Energy beams. If these fall down here, there's a bunch of energy beams, so watch out. Dang it. This is why you want a whole bunch of health swords, not just because of the boss, but because of the level. And once those bombs appear on the screen, you move to the side, they'll explode on their own off-screen, and you can keep on going. And I ran out of time, but that's okay. And here, those droids, you have to wait for them to explode in order to get any hearts from them. Which is really annoying, especially because they release shrapnel when they explode. Dang. I hate those things. Thermal detonator. What? You respawned? What the hell? Okay. Okay. Uh-oh. Ouch. I was afraid of that. Things. I thought they dropped a heart. I don't think the last one did. There we go. Heart shields, yay! See, I think there was a thermal detonator up there, but I just wanted to get the heck out of this level. I've been here long enough. Thankfully, those droids do respawn, at least for a time. So you can get a little bit of health as long as you're careful. Ow! You suck. Well, that one left no heart. And look at that, those claws at this point. The plasma, again, has just enough height to hit them while you're standing. Otherwise, you have to jump at them or hit them at an upward angle. As long as you are firing at these droids, they cannot hurt you with those extendable claws that they have. Blaster power up. No heart. I don't know what's up with that. Again, you can go off screen over here, wait for it to explode, and use a heart. Okay. one more? Yep, we can. Alright. And take out that one. Wait for those things to blow up. Wait for those two to blow up. At the end of the level here. Oh, there was a big part. How about that? I do believe the big parts do disappear after a time. Unless you find them like in a hidden place, kind of like when they appear out of nowhere when you shoot them in the air. I could be wrong on that. I never waited to find out. Okay. Yep, we're finally at the end here. And here's the boss that you don't see, and you definitely don't see in the movie. It's a bunch of stormtroopers and a combat carrier. Roll to get underneath it and try to destroy the center thing first. That way you can have a lot easier time taking the jets underneath it. Although the shrapnel will hit you, it's a small price to pay to take these things out. That's why you want a whole bunch of health swords. And this top one, just hit it at an angle. And then the front one, be a little careful. You can also do... yeah, this will help take it out without taking any damage. Then once every single weapon and jet flame bringer is destroyed, you'll finally take damage, you'll take it out. And there we go. So, alright, so I'm gonna stop the video here, and we'll see you all next time.